We're at the Tollgate Education Center, part of Michigan State University in Novi, Michigan. And today we're talking about thinning apples. And this is a procedure or a process that we go through in the early to mid-summer time. And the process of apple growing is really a two-year process. The flower buds for this year's apple crop really began to be formed last summer in July and August and September and throughout the fall. The apple then developed throughout the winter and flowered this springtime. Now, many homeowners face the issue of having a light crop of apples one year and then a really heavy crop the next year, and then a light and a heavy and a light and a heavy. And the way to break that cycle on the years that you have a heavy crop of fruit to thin off some of the apples, and that will mean that the apples that are left will be larger and higher quality, and more importantly, it'll mean that the tree will put more of its energy into producing flower buds for next year's crop. And so thinning does a couple of things. It not only helps to improve the quality of fruit this year, but it also helps to improve the quantity of fruit that you'll get next year. The process of thinning is something that is pretty easy to do, and usually it occurs in about mid-June through early July, and we usually wait for a time of June drop, and June drop is a time that some of our fruit naturally drops from the tree that hasn't been pollinated entirely or properly. And so you wait to see some apples on the ground underneath the tree, and once you've gone through that time of June drop, then you begin to decide how to thin an apple tree. And in this case, I always start by saying, let's do some cluster thinning. And when I say cluster thinning, I look at a group of apples that are all in the same cluster, and I take them all off except one. And the best tool that I use for that is really handy. It's just your thumbnail, and you simply break off all but the largest size apple and put these apples into a bucket and put them into a well-working compost pile. Now, this apple that is left is going to grow larger this summer, so higher quality fruit, and also next year the possibility of forming more flower buds on this twig are going to be greater, and you're going to have a higher quality and quantity of fruit next year. So let's move up the limb. Now, as I'm doing my thinning, I sometimes see that I have some fruit that is diseased or insect damaged, and here's a fruit with some apple scab. So there's automatically a fruit that I would take off in this thinning process. Here's another cluster of two. Move up, single. Here's another cluster of three apples, and here again I have a little bit of a insect injury. So that's an apple that I would again snap off with my thumbnail, and another one comes off. So this is the apple I'm leaving. Another cluster right here. I take them all off except one. Move up the tree. Take it off. I keep moving up the branch. And so as you move around the tree, you're going to find lots of apples that need to come off. Again, I like to have a 5-gallon bucket close to me and just drop the apples into a bucket. And that then they should be put into a well-working compost pile, and they'll deteriorate in that pile fairly quickly and help your compost as well.